You're just a decent fish, huh? Brought to you in part by St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Strike King Lure Company, number one in fishing lures. Ardent, rule the water. Go on there. Hey, welcome back to Extreme Angler. This week, you know, it's late summer and the water temperatures are starting to fall, drop. And you know, I love to fish top waters and anything that's on the surface, whether it be a frog or popper, anything, KVD splash, Spitting King, it's a lot of fun. It's a great way to catch fish and see smallmouth chasing, you know. The visual aspect of catching fish on top, that's what it's all about. It could be this big or this big. But when the water temperatures drop like this, they're like in the high 70s early this week, and now they're like 63, 64, that surface temp. But it still does something. It triggers the fish to eat, but they might not be willing to come up and just smash those topwater baits like I want them to do and you do too. So you gotta have alternative methods. Jerkbait, crankbait, swimbait. Today, crankbait. Pro model, deep diver. I'm not gonna be fishing real deep stuff. I'm gonna fish between maybe, I'd say between 8 to maybe 12, 13 feet of water. You know, it's a cottage lake. Fishing off the flats and stuff near weed and rock, but it's just about catching fish. I don't care if I get a whole bunch of big fish all day, you know, if I want to go to a Great Lakes and do that, but I just want to catch fish. So today, the crankbait for me, deep diving near those weeds and rock, I'm pretty sure it's going to get me a couple bites. I'll lose a few, but at least I'll still catch fish, have some fun, and figure out again another key to the puzzle to catch them when you want to. And cover so much water too with a crankbait. Toss it out, crank it down a few times, get it down to that depth, then entice them back and forth, slow, fast. See how they want it. See how they want to eat it. Sometimes I throw it out, crank all the way down, you know, jerk it a few times and stop, just leave it there. It sits right in front of their nose because you can't see what's going on out there, but you just know, you can envision they're coming. Whoop, stop and looking. If that thing stops, boom. Sometimes they don't want to commit and chase it all the way. You know, back and forth, keep altering it up. Crankbaits aren't really meant just for casting and just going, you know, that's just like trolling. Work the bait, make it look real. It'll find those fish for you. There we go. Yeah. Good old crankbait, huh? You just take your time. Oh man. Not the biggest mouth ever caught, but he's sure made for TV. Look at him go. Gotta love that, man. Gotta love that. You netter? No, he's just a lifter. On days when they don't want to come up, you go down, and I'm hoping we'll get him a lot bigger than that. But a pro metal crankbait, seriously. You know what? Some days you want to catch them on top on a stick worm or something else. They just don't want to come up and they don't want to chase. They don't want that slow little fall. But the little crankbait, wobbling, jerking it, moving it in front of their face, especially the deep diving one, is a killer. They see it, they eat it. Let's fix up these here and get going and catch one more. And a key to this crankbait bite, seriously, is putting this bait right where they are. You know, I could use a shallow diver. Will they come up? They're not even my topwater. You know, I tried topwater first thing this morning. Nothing. 45 minutes to an hour. I tell you, you gotta make a decision real quick. What do you wanna do? Catch fish or see them on the sonar? I wanna catch them. So I picked the crankbait. The Deep Diving Pro model gets right down where they are, 8 to 10 feet. I'm sitting about 8, 9 feet. So you know, it's right down. Every time I stop, it slowly rises like this. So I'm covering a lot of that water column, because even when I cast, it dives down. If they're anywhere in that 1 to 8 foot level, they'll see the bait. We're gonna get them, boy. Take my time. Chunk it and wind it, look at it. Just let it go. Get their attention. It's real nice when you just stop and all of a sudden, boom, your bait just jumps forward sometimes. But these fish seem to be just munching it. Like, whoa. They see it and it's just like, boom, got it. I like that bite. See, right there. It's another one right there. This is when you grew. That's when you back off right there. You just give it a pull a bit. So we can pull some at the boat. Love the crankbait bite, huh? Gotta love it. See that rod? Look at that, bend that rod. That's why you want a good crankbait rod to do that. Oh, he's barely got it. He might come off this fish. He's barely got it. The back lip, it shows me it just bumped it. Look. Oh, decent fish too. Keep it up high. Oh, look at that. Look at that. See? I'm going to put a few in the box because what I don't want to do, and again, it's just about the angler preference, about putting them on the exact same spot where you're fishing and spook other fish. Okay? Now, if I get 3 or 4, maybe 5, you know, that's my limit, I'll move a little bit, let those fish go, come back, another pass, back and forth, same cadence, same spot, same bait, same result. Okay, when you get bit, side sweep, okay? It's not like a jig sitting straight up. Side sweep, come back, utilize your whole boat, pull that fish towards you. Try to get that crankbait out of his little yap like that. Because a lot of times they clamp down on it like a little pit bull. You want to make sure those hooks find the mark. Utilize your whole boat, side hook set, bring it back, sometimes set again, make sure that fish gets in those hooks, find their spot, those fish end up in the net, and then in the boat. I think this way here, I'm gonna get bit again. Oh God. Oh yeah. Look at that thing. Oh God, hey. Kissing them weeds. That's what you're gonna do right there. Make sure you got some drag, mama. He's a bit bigger. Whoa. Whoa, eh? I think he's a little nicer, huh? You just play him out. Play him out. Let that rod just do all the work right there. Just get him tired out. A little bit of drag. Oh, it brings me to my knees. And he gets in the net. Oh, yeah. Batter fish. They look so big in the water, don't they? When they come out of the water like that. They look like monsters. There, look. Now, didn't he look like a giant in the water? He looked like a giant to me, but he's fat. He's got a big belly. You know, they're eating. He's going to go in the box with the other one just because, like I told you, I don't want to spook anything. If I start getting my mind thinking that something's changed, I'm not going to catch, what did I do? That's a mistake. I want to stay positive, focused, confident. Let's put him in the box. Go on. They're safekeeping. For now, regroup, check my baits, check my knots, catch another fish. See, I just checked the hooks, points. Oh, they're deadly sharp, man. These baits come right out of the package with deadly hook and that knot. And I got a little cross lock snap like that for way more action, no twisting lines. It's the way to go. Bump and bottom again, look at that. That's killer. That's killer. When that little bill is rubbing along the bottom like that, and it's just digging, bumping, digging like this, doing all kinds of crazy stuff, it drives fish nuts. Seriously, even if they're in the most dormant mood, they see that happening, instead of that crankbait just going slow, somewhere around 5-6 feet below the surface, and digging in the bottom like that, that's what you want. You know, a lot of times when you're throwing a crankbait, you got to see where the fish are. Some of those fish first seen this morning were at the back of the bait. So, you know, they're bumping it or just nipping at it. The last couple of fish, like this. or it's right in there. Both hooks are in there. So you know they mean it. So it's just, sometimes it just takes a little bit of effort and patience to be on those spots. You expect them to be, you know, real hot and ready to go first thing in the morning. As the day gets warmer, sun gets up, water temperatures rise a bit, the metabolism just changes just a little bit into a fish. 1 degree, 2 degree water change, that could just be the triggering effect to go from biting the back hook to eating the crankbait. Cottage Angler, tips and tactics to make you a better fisherman.
Andy Montgomery here. I'm gonna tell you about a new bait that I'm extremely excited about. I've had this for probably 2 years now playing with it. It's coming out this year. You're gonna be able to get it this upcoming year. It's called a Strike King Rage Blade. You know, several years ago, the bladed swim jig took the market by storm. But there was one problem with the bladed swim jig. It didn't come through cover real good. It didn't come through laydowns real good. It hung up a lot. We've solved that problem with the Rage Blade. And the reason is when it hits a stump or a tree or a laydown, the lead is actually below the hook. So what happens is it actually deflects the hook away from the cover, away from the snag. So you've got an extremely snagless bait here that you can crank through trees just like we do a square bill. You know, we couldn't do that with the original bladed swim jigs. You can with the new Rage Blade. It's just as good or better than the original bladed jig. You know, the Rage Blade is a pretty simple technique to work. You basically just throw it out, and I like to vary my speed. You know, I'm winding slow, and I may give my rod tip a little pop. I may crank my handle just a little bit faster, but for the most part, it's just a pretty much steady retrieve. You know, when you get a bite on the Rage Blade, one thing I really like to do is I like to kind of set the hook up. You know, I don't like a crankbait where you just kind of pull on the fish. I like a little bit of upward movement in my rod. So when I get a bite, my rod's usually kind of parallel with the water when I'm working it. I want to come here and not here. And you'll really see your hookup ratio increase if you raise your rod up instead of sideways. A lot of trailers I like to use on the Rage Blade, but probably my favorite is the Strike King Baby Rage Trawl. It mimics a crawdad, it mimics a brim, it mimics a shad. It just does a lot of things. Another one is a Swimming Caffeine Shad. You can put just a regular split tail trailer. You know, you can do a lot with it. You can change the trailer and actually have a new bait. So experiment with trailers, experiment with color sizes, and see which one works for you.
That steady just chunk and whining does catch them. A lot of times I try to provoke them, do different things, almost like I'm fishing a small jerk bait. Jerk, jerk, stop, reeling again, slow down, anything to provoke a strike. But something about stopping it, jerking it, moving it, make it like go through a little, like a little bird dog. Let him find the bass, he'll provoke the bass into eating. But just change it up. But remember the cadence you used when you're catching fish. Keep repeating that. There we go. Oh boy. Staying down too. Big brown one, look at him. I just thought he was a pike. He was so big. Oh, look at that. Saved by the net. Didn't have a net that time. Guess what would have happened? That fish would end up another fish story. That's what I'm looking for right there. Fatty, you almost felt like a pike. Nice, long, fat. Look at the big fins on him. Like almost like a grouper. Rawr, grouper. Let's put him in there. Beautiful fish. Beautiful smallmouth. Go on, get in there. Saved by the net, boy, I tell you. A couple more swirls, that could have been a fish story. The only story it's going to be is he's in the boat. Pow! Let's go get another one. Look at that. That's the stuff right there that I'm digging in. Weed. Some people say, man, I don't want to fish near the weeds. You know, I like to fish for smallmouth on rocks and humps and all that kind of stuff. But when you come to cottage country, you better get used to fishing for smallmouth and largemouth-like water, because that's where they live, as well as the rocks near the weed. Come on, fish. Where's you at, boy? Where's Big Mama? Where Big Mama at? Where's them big, beautiful brown bass? I love you fish. Doesn't matter how big they are, they just fight so good. Oh, I just missed another one. Got him. Oh, another one. Not that time. Oh yeah, another good one. Look at that. How many are there? How many times did he eat it? Wow, hey. Eh? Tell you what I'm gonna do. Put a waypoint right there. Oh, look at him go. Look at him go. You got line you can pull. That's it. You can see him below my boat. Look him on the sonar. That's him. You say to yourself, wow, look at all the fish below the boat. That's just him shaking his head all around. Oh, good. Goodness me. How many times you hit that, huh? Was it you or was it a buddy? How many times? Hard to tell. Two, three. Another decent fish, eh? In a box, like I said, a few more. Then we'll put them back. Move around a bit. Put them back. Just solid. Nice thick fish. But that was probably one shot. Two shots. Third time, unlucky for him. But you know what? My gut instinct is telling me I think there's more fish there, because I just caught one there. I put it back in the same spot, real close. Maybe they're schooling a little bit tighter to those weeds. I'm out about 9.5 feet. And when I came by this last pass, I made some casts into that 8, 8.5. Crank, 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 because that crankbait dives to 8 to 10 feet. So you know it's going right through where they are, drives them nuts. If they're in any kind of schooling mode, or there's more than, you know, two or three fish, it just inspires them to, boom, eat it. Let's go. You know, it's so important, even when I'm throwing crankbaits like that, covering water, I know what I'm doing here. This is bait going down between 8 and 10 feet. I'm scraping the bottom. I'm fishing anywhere between 7 to about 12. But I'm always watching my sonar to see if maybe a fish are moving, if fish are there, if there's weed clumps, or if I get a fish and then I drift over about another 15, 20 yards and I start seeing some weed clumps, I'll put a waypoint to give me an idea of reference where I caught that fish. Because I'm fishing that whole little flat like that, it all looks the same. It can be confusing. And a lot of times you catch one, there's two, three, sometimes five in that same area. Watch your sonar, put the waypoints, return those to those same areas where you caught fish, and there's a good chance you're going to catch them again. Kinds of hooks right there. Oh, God, eh? One of those ones that fall right to the boat. I know you did. And then you bashed it. You're so fat. Look at that, just the back of his, under his jaw right there, eh? Under the jaw. Look where he got it. Under the jaw. One of those ones that have just been just bumping it. That's all he's doing. You bumped it. But you bumped the wrong one, this one, didn't you? That makes five, I think. Once I got five, I'm gonna move and then let them go. Five of a kind. The boat got off the trailer just after 7. So for 2 hours, I caught, well, there's five decent fish. 3 or 4 I shook off, maybe 5 maybe. A couple more I lost, but just think about how many hits I had, how many bites. But on that deep diving Pro Model crankbait, get down where they are, put it in front of their nose, they'll eat it. You're seeing what's happening. They're eating it. A little guy. As soon as I stopped it. As soon as I stopped it. Man, it's fun. He don't want to come to the boat. beautiful things. Just a crazy little guy. What I got you, huh? Where? Can I just lean down, grab the hooks, get you off? Can I just do that? Right there. He's gone, not forgotten. You know what? I'm almost done this day. I probably got easy 2 limits now, and there's no complaining. I got a couple really good fish, solid thick fish, bunch of good jumpers, and that's all that matters is catching. Figuring it out, different baits, going from top water to the crank, and it's got all nice little scars on there from those bruising brown bass, and I'm almost done. Well, fishy. There I got it. That concludes my day of broadcasting and fishing with the deep diving, striking pro model crankbait. Caught me a boatload of fish, a load of fun. And next time you go out, you want to catch them on top, or you want to throw stick worms or drop shot, etc., consider pro model deep diving crankbait on those flats like you saw right here on Extreme Angler. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next week. We're going home. Daiichi, world's sharpest hooks. Snag Proof, the leader in weedless frogs. Gamma fishing lines. Catch us at extremeanglertv.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.